Well, welcome back. We have a special treat today. Our guest host, Chef Paul Madison, is also going to be giving us an amazing fall recipe later on in the show. But we couldn't keep you up away from the kitchen for the whole hour, so we're coming in with you now and Chef Alex. Tell us, you're doing a very interesting take on a seafood gumbo.
Yes, thank you. You know, the most important, well, one of the most important parts about a gumbo is the roux. So the roux is the thickener. And, you know, in New Orleans or in Louisiana, they're kind of a lot of French settled there. So they're kind of the French cooks of the South. So so roux became very important in a lot of their recipes. Spice also came into it. So in gumbos and their sort of dishes, they always have a kind of a neat spiciness to it. So we're in this pot, we're sautéing, and we're losing power here, which has happened.
There we go. There we go.
There we go. Yeah, that's how it happens at home, right? There we go. So in the big pot, we're sautéing our vegetables. And so we've got celery, onions, bell peppers, some garlic, and some andouille sausage, which is a spicy smoked sausage. And then in the other pan here, we're making the roux. So this is basically just flour and butter combined together. And we keep cooking, and we keep cooking until it gets brown. I want this to get almost to a... this is a blonde roux right now. The next stage we'll start to see tan and reds and eventually to get to almost like a chocolatey brown color.
I notice you keep moving it, so it's not something you want to let sit too much?
No, it'll scorch on you. It's getting very, very hot. By the time this is done, it'll be 350 to 400 degrees. So you really want to keep it moving and be careful not to splash it on yourself. But it just keeps getting darker in color and richer. It's got kind of a nutty flavor and aroma to it.
It smells great. And you're going to be infusing pumpkin into gumbo, which sounds unusual, but it's a perfect way to kind of bring fall into a great seafood dish.
Sure, and pumpkin is so good. All too often, you know, we carve it and put it on the front porch and don't use it and cook with it. And it's a squash. It's in the squash family. It's got such great flavor, such great richness to it. And this is actually Alex's idea.
Really? Hard to imagine, Alex.
Which is often how our recipes go. I'm like, Al, what are we going to do today? He's like, let me think about it. And he comes up with this brilliant idea, and then I come on TV and take responsibility for it.
Well, we are going to let you and Alex continue on the roux, because you can't leave it alone too long, but we will be heading back into the kitchen at the end of the show to see how the pumpkin seafood gumbo comes out.
Welcome back. We're in Weiss's Appliance Kitchen with Chef Paul from Madison's and Chef Alex from Madison's. So what are you guys brewing up there?
So I think we're looking good. Oh, you want to start cutting the fish? So we've got our gumbo, and we've added the roux, and I kept a little bit of the roux to show you how dark that actually got.
I can't believe that.
Yeah, remember we were cooking before?
That was very dark.
You just keep going, keep stirring, and I mentioned a cliff on the side. You want to stop it just a little bit lighter than this, because that pan is so hot, it'll continue to brown, it'll continue to keep cooking. And then we add some of that to the broth, where we sauteed all the vegetables, added the broth, and that's a thickener, and it's also gives us flavor and gives us the consistency and also the color for the soup, of course.
Something sure smells good.
So then we've got a little grouper, a little fresh shrimp, some clams and mussels. We'll give all that a quick saute. We want to add this to the soup at the end because we don't want that fish to overcook. We want it to be nice and tender and just barely finished. The other ingredient that's really important in gumbo is what they call gumbo filet, F-I-L-E, or sassafras. This is a ground sassafras. And a great little spice, almost thyme-like, but a little a little more floral almost smell to it, you know. So a little bit of that sassafras kind of gives us some flavors.
Sassafras, I've always heard of that.
Okra, gotta have okra.
Yes,
gotta have okra.
Gumbo without okra.
And just a little bit more. A lot of the pumpkin we pureed, but we kept a little bit of it chopped to give it a little more texture.
So the pumpkin in the gumbo is what we're so excited to see how this comes together. And do you add any different spices to gumbo because the pumpkin's going into it?
You know, we didn't, but on the break, Al said to me we should have brought a little cinnamon, a little nutmeg to add and set those pumpkin flavors.
But that's good. That's something you can do to taste, right?
Sure.
Not everyone loves nutmeg.
Sure.
Your andouille sausage is in there, right?
The andouille is in there, yeah. We add that right about the time that we're sauteing all the vegetables and let all those nice flavors cook and simmer in there as well. Ready?
Right.
Oh, did you hit it already? All right, so a little dry sherry to deglaze the seafood. And we want to just burn that off a little bit, get rid of the excess alcohol of that.
Well, that's one way to do it.
Yeah, and that'll just, again, that alcohol just kind of burns away, and you're still left with a nice flavor of the sherry.
Nice.
And then that whole thing can just kind of all come together here.
Now, I have a question when it comes to pumpkin, and I think this people ask this every year. Is it worth using fresh pumpkin and baking it down for recipes as opposed to canned pumpkin? What's your thought?
Depends on how much you have to do.
Okay.
Because it's a lot of work, certainly. Mm-hmm. Oh. But no, I think anything, you got to always get a little better flavor when you're using something fresh. You always get a little
Can you tell the difference when you taste it?
Sure. And I think sometimes you need to make sure you roast it enough so that the flavors really concentrate. There's a lot of oils in the in that squash, and so it needs to cook in. So let's add that fish to the pot now, I think.
Well, and in gumbo, it's nice to have a chunk of the pumpkin like you put in so that you know and can taste what it was before it was cooked down.
All right.
There they go.
All that goes, flavor and everything, juices and everything. And then this is a little, I was skimming the top as it was simmering, getting rid of, you know, some of the fat starts to come to the top and from the roux, from the butter and the flour. So we cook some of that away.
That's a nice trick when we're making gumbo.
Festivities here.
As this is all coming together, speaking of fall flavors, Chef Paul, you have a beer dinner coming up at Madison's in Bradenton. Tell us what we can expect.
We do. Lagunitas is a great craft beer out of California. And so we're going to do a little reception and four courses served after that, $50, great deal.
Oh, nice.
And it's going to be October 17th at Madison's Riverwalk.
That's great. And those do go fast, those reservations, so you'll want to go to madisons.com and reserve your spot for your dinners are always great. So a great way to usher in fall. All right, well, we are serving up our pumpkin seafood gumbo to celebrate fall here on the Sun Coast. Thank you, Chef Paul. Thanks for being with us for the whole show. And Alex, thank you very much for keeping the kitchen intact. All right, we're gonna be doing our tasting.
Yeah.
Cliff, thank you for being with us. Great events, cheers, my friend. All right, you take some time, enjoy the Sun Coast view.